And we've hit the halfway mark in the election campaign. The latest news poll still has Labor looking at victory. However, Scott Morrison is still ahead as preferred Prime Minister.
Stella Todorovic from 10 News First is on the campaign trail and she's in Sydney's West with the Prime Minister and she joins us now. Stella, it's great to see you again. Yesterday, the Prime Minister had a rally in Sydney but was upstaged by one of his candidates. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, he certainly was. Good morning, Tristan and Sarah. Katherine Deves, the candidate for Warringah, was spotted in the crowd by the media. And when we approached her to ask a few questions, she was really quickly whisked away by two security guards, or we think they're security guards. The jury's still out on who these men were. She has, of course, been very vocal about her views on transgender athletes in women's sport, as well as other views that have been deemed racist and sexist. So when we asked her if we could please ask a few questions. Here's how the chaos unfolded. Ms. Deves, just wondering if we could ask you a few questions. Do you stand by your comments that you've made in recent times and in the past?
Are you transphobic? Have you been around
that? If you win the seat, you're going to have to answer some questions, Ms. Deves.
Geez, Stella, did the Prime Minister know that his star candidate was going to attend? It seems very odd.
Ooh. Look, we haven't confirmed whether or not Scott Morrison was given a heads up that she'd be there. We did see him notice her when he was on stage at the rally. He did give her a quick glance. To me, it seemed as though he wasn't quite aware that she would be there. He looked a little bit surprised. He also didn't mention her in his opening remarks at the rally. And then at the very end of it, he did pick up on that and he did mention her and said that Katherine Deves was at the rally. It's a bit odd she was there. I mean, that was really a Western Sydney rally and she was there representing the Lower North Shore. So, yeah, it was very interesting the way that it all unfolded. Quite extraordinary to see her run away and remain so silent when she has been so vocal about these issues that have been deemed hurtful to so many people.
Absolutely. And, Stella, the opposition leader made his pitch to voters in Perth yesterday. Here's some of Anthony Albanese's campaign launch.
My fellow Australians, in just 20 days' time, you can vote for a better future. Cheaper electricity, cheaper childcare, cheaper mortgages, cheaper medicines and Medicare, and for better pay. Today I announce that Labor will make gender pay equity an objective of the Fair Work Act.
So lots of big, ambitious announcements there, Stella. The cost of living as well, which is a huge issue this election, isn't that right?
A massive issue. I mean, the cost of everything is going up. We already know that. The groceries, the petrol, despite the excise, that's going to end in a few months' time. And of course, houses, the housing market as well is absolutely through the roof. So this is something that all Australians are thinking about, and both leaders are really promising that they're going to help bring down the cost of living. We are, of course, Sarah and Tristan, waiting for the RBA to announce and make its decision on the cash rate. We are expecting interest rates to rise. And you guys were talking about the housing market just a short time ago in the program, and I think that this is going to be a huge issue for so many Australians, tomorrow especially.
Yeah. You're with the PM today, Stella. There seems to be a lot of people behind you there, including a lot of families. What will he be announcing?
Well, the Prime Minister started his day bright and early. He's here marking Eid celebrations in Parramatta with his multicultural minister and the candidate for Parramatta as well. We also did spot Kevin Rudd. So that's what we're doing this morning, celebrating Eid. But the announcement today is, again, focused on the cost of living. The Prime Minister pledging he'll help get around 50,000 more older Australians on to the seniors card. This will give them access to cheaper medicine, cheaper healthcare, and also those state-based programs that will help bring down the cost of living. So that's definitely something that's on everyone's mind, and the Prime Minister is really trying to prove that he's going to do a better job than Anthony Albanese.
How are you feeling, Stella? You had a bit of a rough week last week, not just to Albo. You were forced into ISO as well. You were off the campaign trail. What happened?
Yeah, I tested positive to COVID shortly after Anthony Albanese did. It seems I must have caught it on the Albo Express. It was a bit hard coming off the campaign for a week. You know, we are workaholics and we do love the job and it is such an exciting time, but there's 3 weeks to go. And guys, I'm feeling okay. I mean, I have to admit the fatigue is real and, you know, the fog a little bit as well, a bit of brain fog, but I think I'll bounce back. Just got to keep on those vitamins.
Good stuff. Stella, doing
trying to keep up with Scott Morrison.
Yeah. that's right. You can get a full wrap-up of today's events tonight at 10 News First at 5. Stella Todorovic, stay safe. Thanks for joining us.
Thanks, guys. Talk soon.